G'day and welcome to Wine Week. I'm Danny.
And I'm Brad.
And Brad, you're going to kick us off with a Riesling.
A Riesling. Oh, well, for those on Twitter would have seen last night, it was Danny was having a wonderful conversation with some other folks on Twitter.
We were having a bit of a backwards and forwards with vintage cellars and Bennett Int wines. Ooh, which is better, Riesling, Chardonnay, Chardonnay, Riesling? It was going round and round.
Yes, well, look, long-time viewers of the show will know that we love our Rieslings, and with good reason, because here we've got a bottle of Riesling that is fantastic value at around $10, and it's remarkable quality. So this one we've got here is the Hardy Siegersdorf Riesling. So this is particularly the 2009 vintage we've got here from their vineyards in the Clare Valley. Now, what you've got here, and we've talked about this before, Clare Valley, Eden Valley, magnificent Riesling producing regions. But the fact that you can walk into a bottle shop, now admittedly it gets discounted a bit below its recommended retail, but still, if you're looking $10, $12, $15 for a white wine of this quality, it's lovely and crisp, dry finish, but it's got some lovely upfront fruit, little bit of minerality on the palate as well, and you're getting a complete package that is just amazing value. So look, Hardy's, the Siegersdorf, is one of those ones almost without fail, year in, year out. You can put it on your quaffing shopping list for your white wines and you won't be disappointed. So if you haven't tried it before, go out and grab a bottle because you won't be disappointed.
Yeah, and sellers really well. You know, 4 or 5 years from that, it'll be a ripping wine. $10 for a wine that you can sell it for that long, that'll be brilliant. Yeah. Madness! Brilliant madness, though. Anyhow, last week I talked about the fact that I was up around the Rutherglen region for a week or so, and one of the things I love to do when I'm up there is spend the kind of 3/4 of an hour to just drop over the hills into Beechworth, because it's a brilliant region that really is starting to really grow, really shine as well. Pennweight, one of the probably lesser known wineries of the region. You know, we all know kind of Gioconda and Savatier and some of these really big names. Pennweight, the history goes back to the Morris family of Rutherglen. Same sort of family, a little bit off to the side here, doing some brilliant things up around Beechworth now. And this, the 2009 Gamay, a ripper. Mid-20s, yeah, $25-odd from the cellar door. You'll see it around some of the specialist shops. And this gorgeous Gamay kind of sits in that same sort of mould for a lot of people as Pinot. A lighter sort of wine, cherries, a little bit of spice, a little bit of leather in there for some people as well. This is a ripper, and at $25, a cracking wine that you definitely need to try and get your hands on. Their Pinot, almost the $40 mark. $25 for a Gamay just shows that it's not the most loved variety by the wine snobs out there, but like the great French Beaujolais that the grape produces, this can be a great one and a ripper in summer and great with light pastas.
Yeah, Gamay done well really is good as a lighter alternative.
Yeah, love them.
Now, speaking of slightly lighter alternatives, I'm going to have a look at a wine here that caught my eye a couple of weeks ago, and this is the Dunsborough Hills Merlot Cab Sav. Now, you notice it's Merlot Cab Sav because this is actually a pretty predominant Merlot-based wine. We're up around the sort of 80-85%. Now, out of Margaret River, so we've looked at a number of mainly predominantly Cabernet blends over at Margaret River, and the last couple of vintages over there have been fantastic. So this one comes out of 2008, which was a good vintage. Now, the thing that caught my eye about this one is it's a really lovely, approachable wine right now. And price-wise, really good value as well, around the $20 mark. So you don't get a hell of a lot of even the blended wines out of Margaret River at around that price point. But look, it's as I said, the Merlot softens it out a little bit, so it's a little bit of a lighter style, and I know talking to some of my friends, they're not necessarily into the big heavy Cabernets, or alternatively, sometimes the Cabernets need that extra time in the bottle just to soften out and integrate fully. Whereas here you've got a drink now style, but probably benefit from a couple of years in the cellar, but don't be shy to open it up now, and getting some luscious round fruits, but quite ripe as well. So look, Dunsborough Hills, this one's a little ripper that's mainly out of the Merlot grape.
Yeah, look, for Brad to say 2008 was a good vintage in Margaret River, that's the biggest understatement we'll see this month at least. So great vintage.
Maybe the biggest understatement that Collingwood fans went berserk when they won the premiership.
Yeah, that's an understatement, definitely. Let's not think about that. Let's get into some wine and get away from all of that. Anyhow, thanks for joining us on Wine Week this week. We'll see you all again next week.
See you next week.